Yesterday marked the first day of a government shutdown in Samoa as the nation grapples with a devastating measles epidemic. More than 60 people have died and thousands have contracted measles. A mass vaccination campaign is underway, with teams travelling to people's homes to administer vaccinations. But measles isn't the only thing the government is fighting. Anti-vax groups have swamped official social media pages, and one alleged anti-vaxxer's even been charged with incitement against the government. Government vaccination order. Our Pacific correspondent Barbara Dreaver joins us now in Apia alongside Samoa government spokesperson Rico Tupai. Good morning.
Good morning to you, Hayley. Well, we're down here at the government's digital hub. And as you said, joining me now is Afamasaga Rico Tupai, who is the Minister of Communications and Information Technology. Thank you for joining us, Minister. I mean, first up, first day of the big mobilisation yesterday, how did it go?
It exceeded our plans, Barbara. And we exceeded 10,000 yesterday when we were supposed to be targeting 7,500, which is... Now, for us, it's a very good number, and it's heading towards to achieve the objective of government on mass immunization to curb what's happening at the moment. We face challenges. We had lots of challenges yesterday, logistic-wise, even with our own data upload, the smart data coming in. But, you know, yesterday's problem is today's lesson. So today going out, we are... 30% to 50% and a lot more improved in terms of our planning.
Well, more than 10,000 vaccinations that yesterday, that's huge. But, you know, there has been low immunisation rates falling since 2013. Shouldn't the government have done more earlier?
Well, we've always had the immunisation plan and immunisation systems in place. But you know what it's like, you know, people have their own rights. Whether to come do it, you know, even now what we're witnessing now, even those living very close to hospital, 50 meters away from hospital, they have the red flags tying at their fence, meaning that, you know, just a matter of them walking across, it's very difficult. And it's very difficult for government to force people to go do it. So at the moment, hence the program that we're doing. Let's get out. Let's, instead of fixing ourselves in one location at hospitals and centres, let's get out. Let's go to families.
Message to anti-vaxxers, which have done great damage to the situation here in Samoa.
Look, the anti-vax, unfortunately, has been slowing us down. We have families, and unfortunately, you know, we have children that have passed away, only having hospital as the last option. But only that we find out it's a message of anti-vax that's got to these families that have kept the kids in the homes. So what we say to them, don't be in the way of government. You know, don't be contributing to the deaths and the numbers rising, people passing away. But we, you know, we work with WHO. International organisations that give us professional advices, and that's what we're using, that's what we listen to.
Afamasaga, you know, as a Samoan, what does it mean to you seeing the death of little bubbas?
Look, it's... I'm a father myself. No family should lose a child like this. Even I lost my own child when I was 18, and when he was 18 months, not with measles, but... It has had a very profound effect on myself and my family, even up to this point. So, you know, our heartfelt condolences to all families who have lost their child, the children. But at this point, let's come together. Let's work together. You know, what's happened, well, you know, it's lessons learned for everyone. What's happening today, the passing away of your children, that will contribute to a better Samoa in the future.
Thank you very much for joining us this morning. That's Afamasaga Rico Tupai, who's the Minister of Communications and Information Technology.
Barbara, that was tragic and heartbreaking to listen to. Are we expecting the vaccination vaccinations to continue today?
Oh, absolutely. There are teams. They've already mobilised. They've already headed out into communities and villages. There's more than 100 teams doing this. And like you just heard the Minister say, more than 10,000 vaccinations. And I've got to tell you how, like, behind us is this amazing system here. So every time a vaccination is given to a child, it's fed into a phone app. And the information is then fed back here. And it's all mapped out on big maps. They can see which areas have got good coverage and where they're going with that. So a huge amount of planning has gone into this mobilisation.
What is the place like now under shutdown? What is Samoa like? Obviously, you've been there a lot.
Yeah, I come here a lot, and this is actually the first time that I've ever seen such a shutdown, a mobilisation. But you know, we're at critical stage. This is crunch time, and it needed to happen. There's huge numbers of international teams here, and the government's very grateful for their help. New Zealand's got a massive team here. They're out at several hospitals, and also huge numbers of countries like the US, the UK, France and Japan and so forth. So this is really the world coming to Samoa's assistance in this time of need.
As I said, as you were talking about as well, the anti-vax movement has caused a lot of this pain, actually. Yeah. Has the public attitude...
And still are.
Yeah, and still are. But is the public, is the attitude changing towards these anti-vaxxers?
Yeah, I think it is, as the teams have gone out and vaccinating people. And it's not just, you know, having that medical information at hand is really helping. So definitely the anti-vax movement is getting a hammering here, and so it should. This is no time to, when children are dying, this is no time for the anti-vax movement and the people who support it to be contributing to those children's deaths.
And just quickly, is there any, are we any closer to reaching the peak of this epidemic?
I think we're going to see that maybe in the next week or so. But look, that's just a prediction. As it is every day, we are seeing more deaths. The numbers are climbing. There is hope that this massive mobilisation will help put a stop to that.
Thank you so much, Barbara Dreaver, live from us, for us in Apia. We appreciate you being with us this morning.